Neighborhood Health Watch is sponsored by the doctors of HCA Virginia Health System.
All right, if you need your gallbladder removed or hernia surgery, today we are talking about how robotic surgery can help. Gallbladder removal is known as cholecystectomy, and it's one of the most common surgeries. It can be performed through a large incision or with a minimally invasive technique. And hernia surgery used to be painful and often resulted in a slow, difficult recovery. But again, robotic-assisted surgery makes healing much quicker. Great advances that we're going to talk about. This is Dr. Mukong Adeso of Retreat Doctors Hospital. Thanks so much for being with us.
Good afternoon. Thanks for having me.
First, let's just talk about what specifically is like sort of single-site robotic surgery.
When we talk of single-site robotic surgery, we're usually talking about the gallbladder.
Okay.
In gallbladder surgery, the standard is usually the 4-incision laparoscopic approach.
Okay.
But with the robot, we have the opportunity to make a small incision in the navel.
Okay.
About 3 or 4 centimeters. Mm-hmm. Take out the gallbladder, so it's a single site incision in the navel.
Okay.
And what is good about it is you don't see the scar when it heals.
Yeah.
It's less pain.
Yeah.
You go home same day, less use of narcotics, and when it heals, there is no scar because it's hidden in the navel.
Okay.
And that's what makes it a single site robotic gallbladder surgery.
That is just amazing.
It is.
Now let's talk about that for a hernia surgery. How does robotic services make a hernia surgery better?
So let's start off with what a hernia is. So a hernia is a defect in the abdominal wall.
Mm-hmm.
Most people come in because they have a bulge, but the actual issue is the defect.
Okay.
With robotic surgery, we have the opportunity to go in and actually suture the defect closed because the robot has wrist-like actions. Something that a laparoscope doesn't have.
Mm-hmm.
And that is key because you can actually suture the defect close and then place mesh for reinforcement. It is great because you end up with a solid repair.
Mm-hmm.
Patients like it because there's less pain.
Mm-hmm.
You go home quickly, you recover quickly because mm-hmm. there's less pain, and then less use of narcotics because there's less pain.
Okay.
So it's, if you compare robotic surgery with laparoscopic surgery,
mm-hmm.
definitely with hernia repair, the robotic surgery is much more, it's a plus for sure.
Okay, and let's dispel some of the misconceptions about robotic surgery. I'm sure some people think that a robot's actually doing the whole thing, but that's not the case, right?
Exactly, I've had that question many times.
Yeah.
Just because it's a robot, it doesn't mean it's a machine where you press play and it starts doing things. The bottom line is, it does nothing on its own.
Mm-hmm.
The surgeon has 100% control of it.
Mm-hmm.
So it is practically very safe. If you just leave it there, it just stands there.
Mm-hmm.
So it does nothing on its own. You control every facet of it.
You're still in there making it happen. Let's talk about the risks.
The risks, there is no particular risk
mm-hmm.
with robotic surgery compared to, let's say, the laparoscope or the open.
Mm-hmm.
It's basically the same risk.
Okay.
Let's talk about hernias, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Bleeding and infection are one of the two risks.
Okay.
But with robotic, you could actually argue that it's maybe less risk
mm-hmm.
because you have more control.
Okay.
So there's less risk for infection and less risk for bleeding.
Mm-hmm.
But with any surgery, you do have some risks, especially
right.
bleeding
yeah,
and
talk
infection.
Talk it over with your doctor.
Definitely.
Right, thanks very much, Dr. Adeso. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me. It was great.